What is up, my lovely people of the world? I'm about to make a very foolish decision. I've already tried a little bit. I've done a little bit, teensy bit, not much. But I'm gonna try to do some PvP because I came to a realization, a sad, sad realization when I tried to do PvP the last time. I wanted to do it without using parry. There are certain builds that you can totally 100% handle without using parry. There are, like, heavy weapon builds are perfectly... Where are all the summon signs? Where are all the people? I'm online, right? I am online. Right? Oh, there we go. Okay. That's not very many. That's actually a really small amount for the time of day. But so for certain weapon type, if you're using a light weapon yourself, you can definitely get away without using parrying, because you can very easily counterattack with those kinds of weapons. If you're using a heavy weapon, you can hyper armor stuff, and you can definitely beat people that way. If you are using a scythe, people are going to hit faster than you. There's no hyper armor on scythes that you can use. If you're fighting a heavy weapon, you can try and outrange them, but chances are they'll be able to transition from one attack, and then you try to counterattack, and they'll start another attack, and you'll activate their hyper armor, and then you will get bopped in the face. So yeah, I need parry. Okay, cool phantom range. Cool phantom range. It's fair, right? Sure what that was. But so that's why. Like, I honestly think that when it comes to PvP, I'm actually really happy. Like, I should have probably gotten hyper for that. Well, I should say I probably should have gotten hyper for that parry, but honestly, I don't. Like, I have zero respect for parrying in this game. Like, the Cestus is too fucking... Wait, what? Oh, no, that was a... I thought that was actually a scythe move. I was like, wait a minute. But that's so fast. It's so easy to land that, like, I don't... I feel like I have to use it in order to actually be successful with this weapon type, but I don't like it. I do think it's a little... I would really like this game a lot more, I think, if, the parries required you to use like a medium shield parry timing, because that's actually, that kind of actually requires timing and whatnot. I think you can't actually parry that attack, I'm pretty sure. Let me see if I can get him to do it again. Oh, that was bad. That phantom range, though? I just mashed. Like, actually doing this myself? Dude. Zero respect. I don't even respect myself right now. I'm not even like, damn, I'm awesome! I literally mashed L2. The Cestus, ladies and gentlemen. Fair. And there are different types of parries I could use. For instance, if I used a buckler? I don't actually have the buckler. You have to buy it from Grey Rat. But if you use one of the very small shields, it doesn't start up anywhere near as fast as the Cestus, but the active frames of it is ridiculous. So if you have something like that, that's like, you know, he's using that charge, it's super predictable. you have a you have something like that, it's just like goddamn. And so the window to actually be able to do it is huge. It's humongous. So it would be beneficial for that. Perry? There it is. Fuck. I missed, though. There it is. Yeah, see, I just saw them switch weapon types, and I went for it, because I'm a dumbass. Oh. I thought they would parry again. So yeah, I'm a dumbass right there, but that proves my point as well. Parrying is how you win in this game. If somebody is using a two-handed heavy weapon, you pick another weapon that you can counterattack them with that, and you just dodge and counterattack, and what the fuck are they gonna do? If they're not, you parry. And whoever lands the parry, I really feel like if you play 100% defensively, if I just stood there and I played completely reactively to everything, then, well, that's how most people play anyway. If you play completely reactively, you're just gonna have two people fucking standing there staring at each other, waiting for them to make a move, and then nobody makes a move, and nobody can do anything. Because dodging in this game is incredible. There is a very, very minuscule window with which you can punish a roll. And the problem is that online is not fantastic. Online is not the best, is not the best online that's ever existed in video games. And so, when you have a system like that... Let's get a sun, bro. Go away. So when you have a system like that and you make punish windows, it's the same thing with parry. Like, this isn't, oops, this isn't very punishable. You can't see that and be like, oh, okay, cool, they just whiffed a parry, let me punish them. You can't do that. If you try to punish a whiff parry, 90% of the time, you're going to walk into another parry. That's kind of how the game works. And so I'm not trying to say, like, oh, parrying's overpowered, it needs to be nerfed, and... rolling is overpowered and needs to be nerfed, but I do think the actual punishment windows of these actions should be a bit wider. There should be more time to account for the fact that there's no offline dueling in this game. It's all online, and so if your netcode simply is not good enough to support optimal gameplay, then you need to change some stuff so you can actually make it reactionary and not predictive like it currently is. Ooh, that's not parryable. Oh, actually, maybe it, actually, I think it is. I thought that was the spike mace. I cannot believe that missed. Call me the fuck out. Wait for the parry. No parry. He's swinging. Swing again. Nope. See what I mean, though? Like, this is fucking ridiculous. I can't fight that because that has super armor. So I have to try and do this bullshit. Could have parried me right there. Oh, fuck, I'm dead. My bad. That's a weapon unfamiliarity. I don't know how that weapon works. That's the first time I fought that. I just know it's not parryable. There are certain weapons that are parryable, but mostly like the bigger spears are not included in that. I don't think glaives are included in that, but maces, axes, great swords, great hammers. I guess maces are included in the great hammer category. Those weapons qualify as heavy weapons, which you... I think there are some two-handed attacks that are parryable, but the majority of them are not. Great swords, though, for some reason are. Ultra great swords aren't. Great swords are. I don't know. But I do. That's simple fact of the matter is you should have play and counterplay. You should be able to counter things. You should be able to notice somebody has made a mistake and punish them for it. And I don't think the punishment windows for rolls or parry whiffs are enough to allow for that. And thus, that causes a lot... That is, just by itself, that system itself is what causes a lot of my discomfort with this, with PvP, and why, like, there's no chance in hell I'm going to stick with it and try to become amazing. But situations like we had in the middle of that fight right there, where that person's just dancing around, I'm running around like a fucking fool, just trying to, you know, get into their attack range and then walk outside of it so I can do the running scythe attack. Shit like that, that's how PvP is. And it looks fucking stupid, and it is stupid, and I don't enjoy it. But there is part of me that wants to at least gain an understanding of it. Because right now, I definitely don't have that. There's a lot of weapons that I don't really know how they work. There's a lot of various things. Oh, see, Black Knight Great Axe? We can't touch that shit. Oh god, I didn't know that was an attack! Wait, for the follow-up? No follow-up? Okay. I need to learn my ranges. That is a terrible dodge attack, by the way. That right there is the biggest reason why I will never get into this. That's fucking stupid. That's how the game works. Welcome to what is dubbed Phantom Range. You cannot trust what you are seeing. 100%. I should have tried to parry that, obviously. Like, he was very predictable about it, and it didn't occur to me because I've only just started trying to use parry, but that would have been an optimal time to attempt to parry. But yeah, just, you can't trust what's happening on your screen. You cannot trust the hitboxes that you see on the screen. You kind of just have to assume if somebody's swinging, it's probably going to hit you, even if it's a character length away from where, like, you actually are. Like, it's obviously going to whiff. It's not actually going to whiff. It's going to hit you in all probability. And that's my other biggest issue with the game, is the simple fact that you cannot trust what is happening on your screen. And so I mentioned this back when I was playing Bloodborne, because Bloodborne was the first time I ever really tried. God damn it, alright, just give me a new set. Bloodborne was the first time I ever tried to get into PvP at all. And it was the same exact situation, where it was just, the Phantom Range irks me beyond belief, and to me makes combat like this more predictive than it is reactive. And if it was reactive, I would totally get into this. I would probably love it. It would be like a fighting game. It would be like a 3D fighting game, essentially. But it is not. You have to accept that moments like that are going to happen, where somebody is going to swing at you and their sword is going to suddenly triple in length and kill you. This is how it's going to happen. And sometimes the same thing's going to happen with you. Oops, my bad. That's not what I wanted to do. We just wave. We don't do any of that bowing shit. Damn it. He's gonna buff while I'm bowing. I'm gonna get rid of it. Oh, he's spinning to win. He is most certainly spinning to win. What? Reactive. I'm not trying to say, like, oh, man, that's some bullshit. It's just, it's something you have to adapt to. It's something that you have to understand that, again, it's just, it all comes back to you can't really trust what's happening on your screen. I cannot be trying to punish them in their recovery frames, because their recovery frames on their end are over long before they're over on my end. So I have to be trying to hit them in their active frames, and then that will end up hitting them in their recovery frames on their end. It's just on my end, it looks like they're still in the middle of a move, but really they're not. And it takes so much adjustment, and I am not down with that adjustment. Also, you may be wondering, why aren't you using it two-handed? Because two-handed is not as good as one-handed. I'm going to try to do this with Karthus Rouge. And we shall see what happens. Also, I need to go back and spend these souls on more dual charms. I only had two started coming into this. Oh, oops. Bleeds saving my ass! Apparently I should use Karthus Rouge. God damn it. I'm so bad at double sipping. But yeah, so like right there, that person saw I was wielding the Cestus in my offhand, and so they went with the whip, because the whip is not parryable. But I know that. I know a lot about whips now, because I tried to do a challenge run. I was actually going to do a playthrough of it. Of whips only. Bad idea. There are numerous factors at play that caused that to fail. One of them is which, you saw, like, that when they were doing the twirly shit. That three-hit twirl. Well, technically, you didn't see three hits, because I only ever got hit by the last hit. But it is three hits. So, like, the initial hit is actually really fast, really good. Then there's a middle hit in there, which is whatever. I guess it just keeps them staggered. And the last hit is where the damage comes in. But that is the weapon skill. Thus, it costs FP to use. And so that was my big problem with whips early on, is that I think they would be viable. If I shouldn't say viable. Viable implies that they're like completely unusable, which is absolutely false. You can totally, totally use whips and be perfectly fine. So he's using a Cestus too. I'm sorry? Run that by me again? Fucking phantom range, dude. The fucking damage, dude. That is somebody optimally set up. That is somebody completely optimally set up for PvP. They have the absolute ridiculous phantom range of a thrusting sword. They have the stupid spin to win of Exile Greatsword, and they have the parrying of Cestus. That is the trifecta of like bullshit that's available in PvP. Actually, I think the best spin to win item is the Black Knight Glaive, which I hope people don't discover at all. I had a build. What was the build? It was the quality build. I have three main files right now. I have a strength / faith build. I have this one, which is my dexterity / kind of bleed build. And then I have a quality build. So I have a nice, nice rounded. Why am I out of Karthus Rouge? Do I just need to rest here first? Oh shit, I'm out of Karthus Rouge. So anyway, the Black Knight Glaive, I beat the game with the quality character, but the reason why I wanted to make that quality character to begin with was in order to use the Twin Prince's Greatsword, which in order to use that, you have to get the two boss soul weapons available from the Twin Prince's and then fuse those two together to get the Twin Prince's Greatsword. And so you have to beat the game twice, obviously. You know, well, you don't have to beat the game twice, but you have to beat that boss twice in order to get that weapon. So I beat the game, and then I just kind of speed ran the second game, but I played it online. And in New Game Plus, there are a ridiculous amount of invaders in the Undead Settlement, which is like the third area you get to in the game. I got invaded more there than I get here when I'm coming through here. When you have regular invaders, you have the Aldrich Faithful invaders. I did not get as many people running through here normally as I got in the Undead Settlement. And so I was using the Black Knight Glaive because it's a really good weapon. It's pretty easy to win with. For PvP, it's fucking stupid. Not only can you do... I wasn't sure if that was like a faith buff. Okay, get him dancing. Get him dancing. Wow, that is slow as shit. I believe that's missing. That missed? That missed? What the fuck? That dodge is fucking incredible. Like, the invincibility on that shit is absurd. What the fuck? Phantom range? I cannot believe... I don't know if that's invincibility. The invincibility on the dagger move, on the dagger dodge, which is what that little kind of, I don't know, crouch step thing? That's what that is. That's the dagger dodge. It has incredible invincibility. I don't think it's that goddamn incredible. But, fuck. That's something... See, that's another thing that I'm going to have to learn if I want to continue playing this. That's something to learn to adapt to. So what you do about that is you charge. You use an R2 and you charge it for a little bit. You let them dodge and then you let it go. And so hopefully, obviously, the intention there is that you catch them. They try to dodge the regular attack as they see you move. But the regular attack doesn't come out, then you let it loose like a really short moment later and it catches them out of the end of their dodge. But based upon what I was trying to do right there, I don't have a single goddamn clue. So let me... That's really slow. That is really goddamn slow. Do regular throwing knives, they don't cause bleed. That's why I have these, is because they do cause bleed, but that is slow as shit. Like, that will never catch anybody. Fuck it, I'll just use the regular throwing, because I mean the intention is just kind of to keep pressure on somebody and make them keep thinking like, oh shit, this person's still goddamn hitting me, make it stop, versus actually trying to build up bleed. But the kukri is that's terrible. The startup is easily reactive versus these. Look at these, like, that's just, that shit just comes out. How is... I think that would work. So if somebody's dodging, like, they see motions, bam, and then voom, you let it charge for just a brief little moment and you catch them out of it. But it's just, there's so many strikes that that come out and then just don't hit, and I really don't get it. Oh, they're buffing early as shit. Damn it, throw the shit! Alright, so that's a terrible idea. That's not gonna work. Phantom range. Ah, I tried to parry. Welcome to the washing pool, by the way. See, I mean, I fucked it up early by trying to use that dual charm. It's actually too slow. Does anybody ever actually get hit by that shit? They need to reduce the startup of that. There are things that, you know, pay me to balance your PvP from software, and I'll do it. That shit cannot be that slow. Buffs, because, I mean, obviously, probably the intention to that is that you use it in reaction to them starting the buff. But even then, like, most buffs are still, you would still be able to dodge out of that with how slow it is. It's ridiculously slow. But yeah, I definitely, see, that's kind of my big problem, I think, so far with this weapon, is that if you're going to use it, you actually don't want to use it very much. You want to be looking for, you want people to see that you're using it, and then you want to be looking for the parry. Which is not exactly the best scenario to, like, I don't, because the thing is, I don't want to parry. I don't want to do it. It's too easy. I don't like easy. I guess I shouldn't say I don't like easy. I don't like something that isn't skillful. I didn't finish the Black Knight Glaive story. I got invaded nonstop in that area. I think I had a good, like, throughout my time through that area, I probably had around 6 or 7 different Dark Moon / Blue Sentinel people coming in. I had at least somewhere in the realm of 15 to 20 invaders. Every single one of them, except finally the Dark Moon that I was with at the moment died to one of the NPCs in the game, one of the enemies. And so once he died, it was just 3v1, and I wasn't gonna work. I was 3v1 versus a katana user, a warden twin blade user, and a heavy weapon user. I think they were using Yorms. I'm not coming out of that okay. I'm not coming out of that okay unless I manage to catch all goddamn 3 of them in a spin to win, which is, that's unrealistic. But so I finally died at that point. But every single other person prior to them, they didn't die to the Dark Moon or Blue Sentinel people. They died to R1, L2, R2. I wasn't like, damn, I'm so good. Look at me walking through these invaders. No problem whatsoever. You're going to land in R1. No matter what weapon you're using, eventually you're going to land in R1. So that's all you have to do with weapons like the Exile Greatsword, with weapons like the Warden Twin Blades, Godards. You know, if you buff them with the proper shit, all you have to do is land one R1 and the fight is fucking over. It's done. And that's stupid. Are we going? Going, 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 going. Get into attack range and then they attack? No? Yes? No? Yes? There we go. Damn it. That always combos. That was a little too obvious. Damn. I tried to catch it. Shit. That was really close. But see, like, so I really feel like there wasn't any timing to that parry. There wasn't any, like, I understand this move, let me parry it. It was literally just, I see them starting an attack, I hit L2, it worked. And so I really do feel like if I really stuck with this, if I just played this for like a month nonstop, I stayed right goddamn here, I didn't play the game, I didn't go do co-op, I didn't fight any bosses, I didn't try any new weapons, I just sat here with the Cestus in my offhand, and whatever, who even gives a shit about the weapon that's not in my offhand? And it would become so second nature to be able to parry the majority of shit in this game that that's all PvP would become. So Let's see if he's gonna try and do a charge. He is trying to go for the charge. Okay, that's parryable. Do the run, imply something? Shit. Oh, shit. That auto-tracks. See, we're learning. That's the main thing that we have to understand, is that shit like that, I thought that would just keep going straight forward. But nope, that is the Dark Souls way of design. They curve. They will turn. You can't just dodge to the side. So that's something to definitely know. I don't think jump attacks are parryable, right? We gotta finish on a win. Obviously, that has to happen. Our first PvP video has to finish on a win, so be prepared for this to last for the next hour. Sorry. I'm gonna say, actually, you know what? No, this is the last one right here. It's gone on 31 minutes. That's too long for a PvP video. If I were to continue these, for sure, I would absolutely cut out this part. Like, I die, there's what, like, that was a 30-second, 45-second load screen, maybe even more. I'd have to go back and look. It was probably over a minute, actually. I don't know why loading takes so... It's odd to me that loading takes so long in a zone that was just loaded. Because it seems like they probably just load it from scratch every single time, rather than being like, okay, well, I mean, we look at the zone, it's basically exactly how it was. Put you right back in it. But I've never designed a game, I've never tried to optimize a game's loading time, so I don't know how that works. But I don't think this, I mean, especially when you look at something like Bloodborne, how their load times were at the beginning, I don't think From Software is very good at optimizing their load times. And I think one of the examples of that is that Firelink Shrine. If you have not noticed, in Firelink Shrine, they will put up fog doors right where all the exits are. And so those fog doors are because the outside of the area actually is not loaded. And so if you walk up to them, then it initiates the load of the area. Yeah, I need to understand this weapon's hitbox more. See, Phantom Range is gonna work out for me eventually. Not right there, it goddamn didn't! I guess that's a good one. That's a good one to end on. That is the prototypical fight that will cause me to, like, not give a shit about this game, is because of shit like that. Alright, thank you for watching.